Hi, welcome back to the channel. Once again, my name is Ed from Principia Prep, and today we're going to be going over, should you waive the college's health insurance or not? But before we begin today's video, if you are new to the channel and are looking for additional college content, please hit the subscription button down below. It will notify you of when new videos do come out. As well as if you have any comments or any questions, please leave them below in the comment section. We do answer all the questions you guys leave in the comment section. As well as if you do enjoy today's video, please leave us a like. It does help the channel. That being said, let's jump right into today's video. Should you waive the college insurance or not? Now, with the fall semester about to start, everyone should have already received their college bills, or they should be on the way to you. And what you will notice is within that college bill, one of the line items will say health insurance. Now, by law, the colleges must provide all students attending that university with health insurance. This means they automatically enroll your student in the college's health insurance, whether you want them to or not. Now, however, just because you see that line item on the bill showing that you guys have health insurance, it doesn't actually mean it technically actually exists. You have essentially until day one of the student's classes, so the first day classes start, to actually have that removed from your bill. So you have until that day to remove it from the bill. So it doesn't actually exist. So if you want to remove it, you can waive it. So the question is, do you really need it? Now, right off the bat, let's talk about the cost. When it comes to the cost, the insurance itself will be the same cost whether your student's a freshman, sophomore, junior, or senior. The plan of the university is the same for all the students, by the way. However, the cost will range from college to college. So each college's range as far as what the cost will be for their insurance plan will be different. Now, the cost for the insurance typically ranges anywhere for the academic year, by the way, between $2,000 to $4,000. If you want to know the cost of your school's insurance, just contact the bursar's office. They'll be able to give you the number if you haven't got the number already. Now, if you are considering waiving the health insurance, the first thing you have to understand is you have to have insurance in place yourself already, health insurance in place, by the way, for your student. So let's say you already have your student covered, whether it be through the company you work with or maybe through the state that you reside in. The first thing you need to do is, now that you know you have health insurance in place, I would first check with that plan to make sure that your student is covered, especially if they're leaving the state that you reside in. Some insurance plans will not cover your student if they leave the state you reside in. So obviously, right off the bat, you want to check to make sure the insurance plan I have, call them up and ask them, I have my student going off to X, Y, and Z college. Will they be covered if they leave the state that I reside in? Or will they be covered essentially by going off to this college? You have to make sure that your student is covered because of the fact that if you send them off to college and they're not covered, the reality is if you waive that school's insurance and your insurance policy does not cover it and they need to go to the emergency room for whatever reason, the cost could skyrocket and be more expensive than the school you're sending them off to. In fact, an emergency room visit on average, on the high end, an emergency visit could be as much as $20,000 in cost out of pocket, especially if your student isn't covered. Now, let's say you do have health insurance, but they're not covered. The first thing I would do is ask my plan, what can we do to get them covered and figure out what is the additional cost of covering my student to go off to that university? Then you want to kind of weigh the options here. You want to make sure that if the health insurance the school is offering is a cheaper option than in the additional cost you'll have for your health insurance to cover your student going off to college, and then I would probably just keep the school's insurance. That way you have both of them in place to cover yourself while your student's on campus. Now, obviously, if the cost for your health insurer going up a little bit is less than the cost the school's offering you at, then obviously just add the extra amount you have to pay every month in premiums, whatever it may be, every month the bill, to make sure your student's covered at that university. Also, before you're considering waiving the insurance, even if you know or you've already gone through your plan and you know your student's covered, make sure to read everything within that terms and policy, just to double check to make sure you don't need it. I'll go on to Google and I'll just show you how easy it is to find the school's policies. Most of them are online.
As you can see here, I jumped on Google just to make it easy to show you guys how this works. So I'll just choose a random school here. Let's go with Ithaca College in upstate New York. And insurance, there it is. I'll plug that in. And then we'll pop up here, as you guys see. It's very simple. I'll just click on the first link here. And what it'll show me here when I pop the first link, the good thing about Ithaca, and many of the colleges are going to have this on here as well, is if you go down here, it will show you me instantly what the cost for the health insurance at Ithaca will be for the upcoming fall semester, as well as the spring semester, because it covers the entire year. And in addition to that, what I can do here is I go down a little bit further, and it shows me right here if I want to enroll, as far as I want to get the waiver taken care of and waive the health insurance from Ithaca. I can do that right here. I can also, what also makes it very easy to do here, is I can click on over here on the left, the documents and forms, click on that, and the benefit here is, on the next page, it shows me here all that's being covered by the health insurance. So if I want to take, basically print out a PDF or just save it on my computer, I can just click on here and I'll have Ithaca's health insurance PDF. So it shows me everything that's covered.
That you read through the policy available by the college, so that way you're better educated on both plans, what your provider is providing, as well as what the school's provider is providing, because you never know what's out there and what might be additional help to you just in case something goes wrong at the college. So all that being said, let's review real quick. Right off the bat, if you do not have health insurance, the school is going to provide for you. So do not worry, your student will be covered while they're at the college. Second, if your student does have health insurance through your provider, make sure that your provider can cover them when they leave, especially if they're leaving out of the state. Because once again, some providers will not assist you in the process of health insurance if your student leaves the state they reside in, or essentially you guys reside in. In addition to that, you want to make sure if they don't cover it, let's see who offers a better deal as far as cost here. Does it make more sense to increase our policy as far as cost and get our student covered? Or does it make more sense for us to go with the school's plan? And once again, as I showed you in the video here, go through the school's policy, their brochures and everything else, and see what their plan offers. Now, I'd also go through your plan to see what your plan offers as well, because of the fact that there's actually a third option here. In some cases, some of you, it's rare, but it does happen, it does make sense to keep both policies, both the school's policy in place and your policy in place, just in case. Once again, it is rare, but I'd read through both of their policies to see what's available and what's helpful out there. Because of the fact that it's better to be overcovered, to be honest with you, especially when it comes to college and sending your student off to some place completely new, they're not aware of, with different hospitals, different environments, and so on and so forth, than it is to be undercovered. Obviously, since I showed you before, the cost of emergency room could be as high as $20,000. You don't want to have that bill in addition to the premiums you're paying every month through your health insurance, in addition to the college bill you're paying directly to the college as far as tuition, room and board, and everything else. Now, all that being said, if you do have any questions, if you do have any comments, please leave them down below in the comment section. If you watch our other videos, we do answer every single question you guys leave in the comment section, as well as if you do like today's video, please leave us a like. It does help the channel. And if you're looking for additional college content, hit the subscription button down below. It will notify you guys when new videos do come out, as well as on the screen, you see our contact information. If you have any questions, any concerns, if you need assistance with any part of the college process, we do help out with all of it, admissions, financial aid stuff, all of it, loans, etc. Just shoot us an email or give us a call here. We'll be able to help you guys out. Other than that, thank you for watching today's video. Once again, my name is Ed from Principia Prep.